This one's for Hugh Capet, son of Hugh the Great. Dearest directive Solomon, born 941, 996 he was done. He was first Capetian, he said, to health and William and Normandy. Under the Prussian dynasty.
Expanded from slaves which had noted friends in Languedoc, Philip Augustus was labeled the most powerful king in Europe. He was born August 21st. He would fast start fighting, lighting, igniting war with Richard on. He was John of Trust. Richard found a disgusting in Philip. He lost trust. Agnes, his wife, had died bearing two children. Tried to keep Richard in custody, but he was set free at conference. Pope and his son arranged an interdict. He had much attack with Jerusalem, Normandy, took these, Baron of Crusade to take on the Albigenses. His wife, Ingeborg, would have to put up with his abuses. Using his force of conquest, he would have dominance. Philip II was once the seventh Capetian king, fell down from collapse, bridging almost drowned, safe and sound. France would benefit. Philip was significant, created a tough empire, as well as a fitting strong government.
The holy man, a pious king, became the king of France alone. Girl's father had died. On his way to soon return, led them up, then stopped, kept the clergy and papacy, stabilized the currency. Before he rode with power, so his banished to 1242, Louis had defeated the 13th Henry, founded a limited abbey, Louis the 9th, and was died in August to his mind, the wretched sea, and entrusted the administrative justice. So his count of Clermont became the king of France, he was 12 years old. He was a true Christian on the crusade to Tunisia, sadly could not stay. He went to Tunisia, happened to be his last crusade. He was also known as Louis the Saint. Canonized feast days, here was really stupid, but that guy, Lord Farquaad. Although his force was truly awesome, he had led the 7th crusade in 1248.
Now back to Hugh Capet, his lands expanded across Europe. His uncle was Holy Roman Emperor. Since his father had died in 96, he was assigned position of Duke of the Franks. Had lands from Paris to Orleans. His wife was named Adeline.
By the time Philip lived in Pope Boniface was Audi. King Philip IV would go to power in 1276 after Louis became a little drowsy. His pope wanted to say, the bishop of Pamir told him he's not a man or a beast, he's a statue. And King Philip IV isn't scared of nobody because he destroyed England and France, making friends and signed a peace treaty to show them how harsh of a king he could be. And how he would humiliate them to show it. King Philip also suffered defeat. His nobles got a bad rap because of the loss in Poitiers in 1302, which embarrassed himself and his kingdom. He would later redeem himself in Mons and Pavel in 2 years. Philip wouldn't stop once he reached the top, taxing clergy to increase power. That's when he reached the scary drop, when he wanted French support, he created the Estates General. His life was going great until his sons broke the treaty in 1305, like some immature royalty.
He's crazy now, he ordered to have murder Louis, Dr. Orleans. He was figured now, I'll tell you how. He was too young and unstable to take the crown. He was fooling Charles VI with England's attempt to make peace. On May 20th, he signed the Treaty of Troyes. Charles dealt with madness, he had glass delusions. He was too afraid to move to keep him from shattering. Son of Henry and Catherine, 1422, he died. He did not move so he would not shatter. So for hours, he would sit in his room, crazy, see me, we fly.
He died, he was called King Charles Wars. He is the father of Charles VI. Of the House of Valois, he will pass from 1364. Till he died in 1349. Charles V got lands like Dauphine. His grandfather set the scene. His father was Prince John of France. He fought in the Hundred Years' War. He led French's armies that bore. England held him ransom for $3 million. When he died, he lived in Normandy. Charles VI took his place eventually.